Ask them, are you wearing the armor of God today? I'll turn to that same person and say, because you look beautiful instead. Yes, it is very important that each and every day that we wake up, we put on the armor of God and go into battle, because we know that the devil seeks to destroy and steal. If you're unfamiliar with the armor of God, it says in Ephesians 6:13-17, then we will put on the full armor of God so that when the day of the devil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything to stand firm then. With the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to this, take up the shield of faith, which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Amen, church.
Oh, For those who are watching and joining us together in the Word,
there's
a fabulous opportunity
to
give us the right message. No doubt there are many things to
be done,
but there is something in the right time that He's
concerned
with. In the generation
we live
in. Job, first chapter. God has placed it deeply in my heart. Challenges in these last days. The days are getting more evil. And in regard to that, God has given us more blessings.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Job
1 verses 6 to
8. But I have my foot as a tan and book now told. But I behave as Jehovah as a tan. Go how be fair. The tan is a tan and get show up here. May he ever forget a mirror in my money. Moeku, fear of the fano, yai. Best fano, but I behave as Jehovah as a tan. Walk a photo of a lie at the Tamayo Eki go shop it. Help me die, have a town in my money. But I don't know how I want a ton. Of one of a hair to get out one.
The big thing to bring is a blessing for us today. We need to understand our lives that He should be proud of us. He needs to be proud of your life. Tell the person next to you, God should be very proud of your life. Maybe it's difficult for the one next to you, maybe he knows
something.
Maybe he can see something. What we need is as Christians today.
And
our lives may be a life whereby He is proud. Whereby that He notices the very life we are living. This well-known story. Place in my heart to share with you. How God had noticed your
God.
The time and generation He lived. So the sons of men came and came. Presented themselves before the Lord. Satan also came along to the
meeting.
God said to him, where hast thou been? And he said, going to and fro. Roaming around like a roaming lion. Seeking someone that he may devour. God reminds us he comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
But
it says that the Son of God before the Lord. And when they came, God said, Satan, have you not noticed my faithful servant? My faithful servant. Think about it this morning. As we come together, would God notice our very lives this morning? Within Sydney, Australia, amongst the billions of people, would God notice where we're heading? Would he notice the stage we are in? But I want to remind us this morning. Instructions that is given to us. The reason why we are Christians is that our lives may be proud. The reason why we come to church different from all other gatherings. We come because we know what we are doing. Those who go to the drinking of coffee, that is the reason why they are there. Are other gatherings together. But we come to God. We know the reason for being here. We know where we are at. We come knowing His guidance. Irrespective of what we face, His grace is abundant. God says He's faithful and true. Just to forgive any person, no matter where you are at in life. That is the grace we live by today. That we have a loving God. Loving kindness can never be taken. We notice where we are in life, in the state that we are in. The question posed, would God notice the life that we are living? Likewise, that He noticed Job. God said, Satan, have you noticed my servant, Job? There is none like him in uprightness in the world.
Amen.
No doubt there are famous people in the world. People would try to imitate them. The kind of style they would use. And they would follow
accordingly.
And to follow that kind of life. That is my desire,
John.
He would be a model for
him.
Why?
Because
God had noticed Job's life. No, that would be useful for us. The challenge of the word today. Firstly, God says, Job is a blameless person. My servant is a blameless person. Firstly, I want to encourage us today. The importance to make our lives blameless. To make ourselves right in the sight of God. Matthew 5 and verse 28
tells us,
therefore be perfect, just as your Father in heaven is perfect. Know the God that we serve.
He's a perfect God.
That is the desire what God had noticed
in you.
This is the life that He is living. My servant is blameless.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Tell the person next to you, we need to be blameless. The Bible tells us, you will come to a bride that is without spot or blemish. That is therefore to be like Him. Firstly, our Father is blameless and perfect. That is the desire for His children. That we be just like Him. Maybe you may say, Pastor, there are many mistakes. Blameless is not within you. Can I say to you
this morning?
There is still an opportunity. Make it so blameless. No longer be available. But now is the accepted time.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Nothing
else can make us blameless but Christ alone. And so there are many Christians today. Difficult for them to follow according to the will of God. No doubt God has blessed His church abundantly. Jesus said, he who wants to follow me must first deny himself, pick up his cross, and then follow me. A young man came unto Jesus. Matthew 19:17. He said, Jesus, what will I do to attain the kingdom? Eternal life needs to be acquired of us. And it's not just willing to be according to our desire. We must live according to what God requires of us. Us No doubt this person had importance on every aspect of life. Because he noticed that there was something more to life. This is what you need to do, he said. Have you fulfilled the commandments? What are those commandments? Jesus said to him, do not murder. Do not be do not steal. Do not therefore respect your father and mother. And to love your neighbor just as yourself. Praise the Lord. So the young man said, yes, I must do this. Then am I an attacker? If I do not do these things, neither will I attend. No doubt we desire to reach it. I ask you all who are saying it. If those who are watching, they want to go to hell. No doubt nobody wants to go to the fire of hell. But there is something needed to be done. This is what you need to do. You must forsake this. Turn away from this kind of lifestyle. You shall not steal. You shall not murder. You will not do these things that I command. Lord, I have attained this since I was a child. Jesus said, if you want to be sell all that you have, give it to the poor, and then follow me. Church of God, following Jesus daily, not just on Sunday, not just through program, but as a daily living. Jesus said, you must take up your cross daily. We must follow him daily. What is the reason? So that we may attain eternal life.
Aí ela disse, ruim de contar outra fala aqui.
May I ask you, do you want to get ahead? He said, no, immediate prayer is needed. And so the young man was sorrowed by
that.
Because what Jesus had said did not go well with his heart. There's a difficulty with Christianity today. It's our heart. When he commands us, it is difficult for us to forsake ourselves. Before we were to move with my family to New Zealand, I received the calling to go back because of his work. Very difficult for me in my heart.
How many times before you went out?
And I had enough of trying to survive with the family. Went to New Zealand, had a good job, good things for the family. And I felt that this was the right time to go. Talking about something that God has placed in your heart. Struggling within our hearts.
It
commands us to leave that, yet we struggle with
it. It
commands us to do something, yet we
struggle with
it. Message this morning, God requires
for
him to be proud of our life. We need to be blameless. We need to live a blameless life. Jesus said, if your right eye is causing you to hinder, take it out. That you may obtain eternal life. That if your hand obstructs you, better to go one hand. That you may have eternal life. That is the difficulty we find ourselves in life, to be blameless in his sight.
Hallelujah.
And the Bible says that Job's children, they celebrated, decided to come and bring a sacrifice before God. Thinking that there may be something within him that is not right before God. Maybe somebody has blessed
him.
Such was the state of life that Job was in. He did not desire to have anything that is wrong before him, before God. How about us today? After work, we go home. We forget to say sorry, Lord, for the things that are mistakes that I've gone through. Yet we rest. Yet this gentleman's job was much different. He wanted to make certain within his life that nothing
could be stopped.
And no wonder God was proud of
him.
That the state of life where God will be proud of our life. To be no when we say no.
To
so yes when we mean to say yes. Shared with the president, went with a friend. Farm that he had. And this person said to me, buy alcohol, we'll go to this place and yet he had known I am a pastor. Sorry, but I do not. He said, just once as we go together. And I said, no, I shall not. He said, no, you have to.
He
said, stop the car, I'm going to try and find my way back home. He said, what is the reason
you're asking?
And I said to him, I am a true Christian. I'm not a plastic Christian. We say we are Christians, yet we live a different lifestyle. We need to reveal the way that our life is. Nothing is hidden before God.
You're
sitting down and standing up.
Even
the numbers of hairs we have. He already sees
the
in the midst of the universe. Genesis 6 and verse 9 reminds us what he had commanded Noah. He was faithful and blameless before God. In his generation.
Church
of God, I want to challenge our lives.
Yes.
Not to concern that you'll be upset with
me.
Our responsibility is to instruct
you.
They reach the life we are hoping for. It's not merely through family. Not just through friends. We must make sure our life is blameless. It is worthy the will of God. Or if not, then eternal life will not
pass.
No wonder why the word says, many then who are shall call, but few are chosen. Because everything must be in place. We need to know what
state
of life is. God reminded Satan, not only is he blameless, but he is an upright man. That is why God will be proud of us.
He
should be blameless. Secondly, we need to be an upright man. Chapter 7, verse 9. That you may know God. He is a faithful and upright God. He keeps all his commands. Loving kindness to those who love him. And do according to his statutes. Thousand generations. You know the faithfulness of God.
It's
from generation to generation. Generation will come yet he is still faithful. Come to such a time when he will return. He will do according to his commands.
Church
of God, I want to challenge us today. And you are not upright person.
So
you
know, when you go for I'm the poor, poor.
And you want today that God will be proud of us. We need to be faithful.
And I told we have made a
in all things.
And I told we had done what I
in our tithes and offerings. To be a good steward in what God has blessed in your
family.
In your family to be faithful. That is why God will be proud of our lives. That is why God will be proud of our families.
What
is the reason? Because of the nature and character of a faithful life. Praise the Lord. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise. He's a good God toward us. He helps us in our need to be faithful. He helps us to understand that faithfulness is faithfulness, there is a place being prepared for them. Psalm 112 verse 1.
Psalm says that fewer are the faithful. I want to challenge all of
us.
It is not merely a message for you.
It
is only to be able to make ourselves right. For those who are faithful before us, so reach the place that
you have to be.
That is the challenge for us today. Matthew 25 reminds us, when they came with their talents and presented it before the master, this is the answer he gave to his servant. My good and faithful servant, all that you have shall be added to you. Not only enter into the joy but there was a person who was not faithful. One talent, yet he did not work it. This is the answer that the master gave. You wicked servant. This is the life we are at today. We shall stand before him to give an account. It is very important for you and I. Passing on the loving voice of God. I do not know where you are in life. You do not know where I am in life. But that is the challenge for us today. God was very proud of Job's life. Blameless, upright person in the sight of God. Let me conclude with this. It reminds us God, he feared God. In all the times we are living in, scares are people who fear God. They say, how do you know that, Pastor? The life that they are living. The words that you speak tells me you do not fear God. The fruits of your labor tells me you do not fear God. But Jesus said, you shall know them by their fruits. We want to challenge our lives today. We're here to encourage us, Mount Zion. He does not desire that one soul be lost. His desire that we would all obtain. He says, I'm going to prepare for this. I'm not here to judge anyone. I'm here to tell you the nature of heaven, whereby God will be proud of us, and we will reach eternal life. This blameless, an upright, faithful person who fears God. Fearing God is to shun evil. It is to turn away from evil. So I want to encourage us today. Coming to the conclusion of our message. God's desire for you and me. Wherever you may be in the world. And you may be proud of where you are at your
faith.
If you are here today. You desire to be a blameless and faithful person in the sight of God. You desire that God will be proud of your life. It is not late. He's a loving God. We are blessed. We have a God whose love is incomparable. Yet what we were sinners, he sent his only begotten Son to die on the cross, to forgive, to save, and to bring us to from the death that we were and here to come. No matter where you are, no matter what family you are, one day we will stand before you. And the faithful shall be set apart. Those who heard but did not do according to the word. God's love is still calling towards you. He still stands at the door knocking. Saying, son, the opportunity is for you. If you are watching today, the opportunity is available for you. We know not the hour, nor the day, but he will return to take his people home. That is the loving voice of God. Young son, God desires to save us. That is his love. No concern about what you have gone through. In this moment, this opportunity is faithful and true. When we come into his presence and say, Lord, I'm sorry. He's faithful and just to forgive us. Whilst our eyes are closed, I want to give an invitation. You want to renew your life before God. It is available to you. The opportunity to do, make a move. No longer need to look to God. They will not be able to see the upcoming sorrow of them. But it is for you to choose for your life. It's available for you if you want to receive Christ. If you want to renew your life in his presence, this is a time to fear God. That we may shun evil. Please, if you will rise to your feet. The altar is available. It's available to you.